Hello and welcome to my talk about ESP Bench, the Enterprise Stream Processing Benchmark. My name is Günther Hesse and this is work done by Christoph Matthies, Michael Perscheid, Matthias Uflacker, Hasso Plattner and me. We are from the Enterprise Platform and Integration Concepts Chair at the Hasso Plattner Institute at the University of Potsdam in Germany. So how did we start? We overall observed that there's a growing amount of data. While Spotify analyzed about 1.5 million events per second in 2016, this number rapidly grew to about 8 million in 2018. One kind of system that is in particular well suited for analyzing such huge amounts of data, such streams of data, are data stream processing systems. We also recognize that this kind of technology is becoming increasingly popular, and then that there is a growing number of data stream processing systems overall. While having a large number of systems is generally a good thing for users, it also imposes certain challenges to them. So, for instance, it leads to the question, which system or which setup is the best, so with regard to software, configuration, or hardware for a given usage scenario? And how can we compare systems or setups quantitatively? The natural solution for that is performance benchmarking. However, there's a lack of satisfying benchmarks in this area of data stream processing systems. So for instance, regarding the coverage of all data stream processing system core functionalities, which is not existent for most of the existing benchmarks. Moreover, the integration of business data, so where business data and streaming data is combined, which is very crucial for businesses, for enterprises, in order to understand the holistic value chain. Moreover, there's a lack of comprehensive tool support, which is in particular crucial for data stream processing scenarios where data streams need to be reliably created and where objective result calculation needs to be. So we tackled this challenge by proposing a new benchmark called ESP Bench, a benchmark for enterprise stream processing architecture. An application benchmark from the high-tech manufacturing domain that comes with a comprehensive tool support for instance, calculating the correctness of the query results or the performance results. Moreover, the benchmark queries cover all core functionalities of data stream processing. So windowing, transformation, aggregation, filtering, join of streams, machine learning capabilities, and the mentioned combination of streaming data with historical data. But how does ESP Bench look like? Over here, you see the overall architecture of ESP Bench with the input data at the top, below the ESP Bench toolkit that is provided with the benchmark, the message broker below, and the system under test at the bottom with the data stream processing system and the database management system. Following slides, I will explain these components in more detail. The input data is present as CSV files. And in particular, there is business data, so ERP data that is inspired by the TPCC database benchmark, and streaming data that is mostly taken from the DebtSquon Challenge 2012. So that is sensor data from high-tech manufacturing machines that measures certain values. For instance, the electrical power on certain main phases that is consumed or the state of chemical release valves. Data generator is one of the ESP Bench tools that generates the business data mainly, and then can be configured with the provided configuration file order to scale the data. The data sender is the second tool of the ESP Bench toolkit that has two major responsibilities. First one is importing the business data into the database management system. The second one is reading the sensor data and sending it to the message broker. The data sender can also be configured using another configuration file. Configuration parameters over here are, for instance, the ingestion rate, so whether data is sent to the message broker with 1,000 messages per second or 10,000 messages per second or more, and with respect to the duration. The message broker decouples the data sender and the system under test, which allows to, for instance, scale the data sender independently of the system under test. Whether we execute one data sender or 10 data senders, that doesn't affect the very implementations of the system under test. For the message broker, we use Apache Kafka in particular, which is a very, very commonly used message broker that you can find in many, many data processing architectures in academia and industry. So it represents real-world architectures. And Apache Kafka provides a certain feature which we use. In general, Apache Kafka organizes data into topics which you can send data and subscribe to. These topics are technically distributed append-only logs. The feature we use is the log append time feature of Apache Kafka, which, if enabled, stores the timestamp to each message once it is appended to the Apache Kafka log. We use these timestamps stored in Apache Kafka to calculate performance results, so to calculate the latencies independently of the data stream processing systems, which allows for an objective result calculations between different systems. So the system under test, as I mentioned before, includes a data stream processing system with the query implementation and a database management system that stores the business data. For the DBMS, we use Postgres as default. The query implementations of the query reads the data from Apache Kafka and, if needed, from the database management system, and then, depending on the query, stores the results again in Apache Kafka or in the database management system. After the data sender and the query is finished, the result calculator and validator is invoked. This tool again reads the input data from Apache Kafka, calculates the results, and compares the results to the results produced by the system under test, so to determine the correctness of the results. Moreover, this tool calculates the latencies, as I said, using the timestamps stored in Apache Kafka along with the messages. But how does the benchmark process look like? It looks as follows. And to ease the use of the benchmark, so for simplicity reasons, we automated the entire benchmark process using Ansible scripts. So only a single command needs to be executed in order to run the benchmark. The single steps are as follows. First, we set the benchmark parameters and compile the ESP Bench toolkit. The second step, we create and reassign the Apache Kafka topics. Reassignment is performed in order to ensure that the topics are evenly distributed across the Apache Kafka cluster so that there are no unintended bottleneck at the Apache Kafka side. The third step, we generate the business data, which we then copy to the database node and where we import the data then. Next, we start collect D on all nodes. Collect D is the daemon we use in order to collect certain system KPIs, such as the memory utilization or the system load. Afterward, we start the benchmark application and then invoke the data sender. Data sender runs for the configured time frame, and then we wait a few seconds for the benchmark queries to be finished, and afterwards stop collect D and fetch the gathered data. Last but not least, we run the validator and result calculator. But how do the queries defined by ESPBench actually look like? These are the five queries defined by ESPBench. The first one, for instance, being the check sensor status query, which creates or calculates certain sensor statistics, average, minimum, maximum count for tumbling windows of the last second for the attribute electrical power in main phase one for monitoring reasons. So to monitor if everything is working the machine as expected. To prove the functioning of ESPBench, we implemented these queries using Apache Beam, an abstraction layer that allows defining data stream processing applications that can then be executed on any of the supported data stream processing systems. We developed this example implementation and used it to benchmark three state-of-the-art stream processing systems, in particular Apache Flink, Hazelcast Jet, and Apache Spark Streaming. Over here, you see the latency results for first query, the check sensor status query, for an input rate of 1,000 messages per second. You can see the benchmark set up on the right-hand side. We can see that Hazelcast Jet outperforms Apache Flink for this query, with 90th percentile being below 1 second, versus more than 10 and a half seconds for Apache Flink. Surprisingly, Apache Spark Streaming did not output the correct results with the very same Apache Beam application, which is a very interesting finding for two reasons. So first, it shows that you cannot assume that the same Apache Beam application executed on different system outputs the same results. And moreover, it indicates how important a correctness check of the query results is. We provide a tool for that with ESPBench, but many benchmarks do not provide any help at this point. The results for the other queries are part of the paper. So to sum it up, we propose a new benchmark for enterprise stream processing scenarios that provides a comprehensive tool support and covers all core functionalities of data stream processing. Moreover, we provide an example implementation using Apache Beam that can be used to instantly analyze different settings, different hardware, and different systems. Furthermore, we benchmark three state-of-the-art stream processing systems with ESPBench, and the example implementation prove the functioning of ESPBench. For more information about related work, we invite you to read our paper. Future work includes the extension of the ESPBench benchmark to further data and queries like geospatial scenarios or data. Moreover, future work includes the extension of the evaluation regarding certain aspects like scalability. Thanks a lot.